Welcome. Thank you guys for being here. I'm not sure what the microphone situation is. We will figure it out or we won't. We will use our voices or we won't. We found out.
We discovered the microphone situation. Yes, we got it. Excellent. James Dobson. We are so grateful to every one of you here for the love, support, and for a large percentage of the people gathered here, the work that you've put in to make this wedding such a special event for Lindsey and Seth. Not everyone gets to lay claim to such a loving and generous community as the one gathered here right now. I can't tell you how many times Lindsey has gotten teary-eyed to me about how another one of you has volunteered your time or hobbies or efforts to make this so special. It's overwhelming sometimes to find out how much you're actually loved. I've seen Lindsey a lot in that space over these past few months. So for me, from Seth and Lindsey, thank you. Your efforts, your heart, your contributions, they are appreciated more than words will ever really say. As we get started, you may notice our photographer and videographers are working. Oh, please be seated.
I'm standing, we're standing.
Oh, yeah. Side note.
I thought you wanted me to.
You're getting cardio in for the wedding, okay?
All the preliminaries.
That was awesome.
As we get started, you may notice that our photographers and videographers are working around the back to make sure they capture everything that happens here. So please take a moment and silence your phones, set them down, and just be present as possible with us as Lindsey and Seth and Ava and Rowan take this next pivotal step into solidifying the relationship as a family that will bolster and strengthen them in all the years to come. When Lindsey asked me to officiate their wedding 2.5 years ago, we didn't have a clear picture of what we wanted this moment to look like, other than a heartfelt declaration of their commitments together in the presence of the people that they love. But since that day that she asked, I've been observing their relationship maybe more closely than I normally would have, with an eye to answering the question, what is it that makes these two so perfect for each other? And I've realized that they've got some really unique strengths that not every couple has. And I've come to think of them as their power tools. Because these are the natural strengths that you two are gonna fall back on for the rest of your lives to build your strong-ass foundations and to fix shit when it breaks. Because life happens, and sometimes shit breaks. And when you've got power tools, building and rebuilding is so much easier. The first and most obvious natural strength I want to highlight about these two is their capacity for play. If you're ever going to describe Seth and Lindsey to anyone, one of the first things you're going to talk about is how much fun they are. Fun comes naturally to both of them in a way that I personally am a little jealous of. Somewhere along the way, I bought into the story that growing up means getting serious. And over the last few years that I've known these two, they, along with my husband, have helped me unlearn that story. Because while fun and play can seem superficial and silly, life is hard, and stuff gets real faster than you can ever imagine sometimes. And when as a couple, you can easily default back to play, hard stuff can be a lot more bearable. So my hope for you two is that as life, as serious as life gets, you never lose your capacity for play. You never underestimate how valuable and important that natural inclination is. Nurture that shit.
Swing.
It's seen you through some hard stuff already, and it's going to serve you and the people you love for the rest of your lives. Which brings me to what I see as your next power, your ability to create community. Look around you for a second. Every one of these people love you, like really love you. You have your blood family, who are those people that you navigate life with your entire life. You bump up against them, you learn to love, fight, play, forgive, cry, and so many more things. Blood family are in our lives one way or another from the moment we're born until the moment we die. Chosen family are just that. People who choose to be here because they love you, because they enjoy being in your presence and want to be part of your world. And it's not by magic that you have got both. I think of all the ways you two invite people into your lives, embracing their differences, celebrating their strengths. You two both have a way of making people feel good in your presence, of feeling loved. I mean, seriously, how many meals have you delivered to somebody who is going through something hard?
So Georgia.
That you both are so naturally strong at building community makes you a powerful couple. It makes you stronger together. And if you continue to nurture that, it means you will always have people to lean on when things get hard. Which brings me to our next power tool, which is you have huge hearts. Having a huge open heart means it can be easy to get hurt. And for some people, it becomes not worth the risk. But you two continue to be up for it. I've seen it. Having a huge heart that knows how to ask for what it needs, say no more to what doesn't work, and continue to love yourselves and others, guys, that's the shit. This may be the best of what life offers us. We've all known someone who has it all and can't be happy.
No, keeping your hearts open.
Loving fiercely, forgiving when needed, it allows you to be happy wherever you are. And the fact that neither one of you is at all stingy with your hearts is part of what makes you perfect for one another. And the last one I want to mention, because it pairs so well with your capacity for play, is determination. I think these two had been together maybe 4-5 months tops when Lindsey introduced Seth to all of us at a lake barbecue, telling the entire crowd that she was going to marry him. Seth's response was that iconic, "Yeah, all right." I didn't know at the time whether to be still sorry for him or congratulate him. Because I knew Lindsey well enough by then to trust that when she wanted something, she was going to find a way to make it happen. What I didn't know then was that Seth has his own healthy dose of that same kind of determination. It's one more reason they work. So while you're both so good at play and loving and creating a community of people to enjoy your lives with, you're also both so fucking determined to make it work. Lindsey, I'd known you about 5 minutes when I realized there was nothing you cannot do. I've never known a woman more naturally capable than you. And Seth, when you talk about joining this family and taking on the responsibility and the roles of dad to these two awesome teenagers, it's like you're dropping the truck into four love. Your determination to do whatever it takes to make this work is awe-inspiring. I love you two, independently and together as a couple, more than I can say. And I am so honored to be here with you, launching you into this next phase of your lives. So at this point, we want all of you to infuse your hopes and blessings for the couple into this ceremony. So we're going to pass the rings around, and we invite each of you to share one word, a quick phrase, that you would like them to carry forward into their lives. And as you say it, feel yourself dropping that energy into these rings that signify their commitment to one another. And if you're super shy, you don't have to say it out loud, but please do take a moment to offer your wishes for them into the rings. And we're starting up here. You can stand. Thank you. Remember to communicate.
Congratulations.
Don't ever forget. Passion, forgiveness, and some bodacious adventures.
I was going to say, keep going.
Just have fun.
Red hot.
It's getting juicy as we get first.
We'll come around to this show.
May every day be your honeymoon.
I like that.
Love each other like home.
You know, much love, you guys. Love you forever. This is amazing. I wish you trust and faith.
Congratulations, you guys. I think you got it.
Dedicated and resilient in your love.
Always let your love be the compass that guide you guys. You'll never go astray.
Never change and always remember why you guys fell in love in the first place.
Marriage comes first. Put it first and everything else will come after.
Survive together no matter what.
Don't bring a 3-year-old to a wedding.
We're excited for you guys.
Congrats. Glad you guys found each other. Stay rowdy.
Wishing you bliss forever.
You remember, life's always better with a teammate. So.
Cheers, and I hope you have more beautiful days just like this.
Choose each other first.
wishing you a lifetime of adventure, continued kindness, and continued determination. You guys are amazing.
Love, love, kindness, and creative adventures forever.
Congratulations.
I love you, Cece Lindsey. I'm glad you're so happy.
Congrats.
Stay silly.
If you're ever in a fight that seems unsolvable, you either need sustenance or sex.
Yes!
Both.
How do you know?
Thank you.
The couple has chosen some things
that we've asked Stephen Klein to come up and present.
All right, let's see if we can get the microphone to work here. Hey, guys. Congratulations. So I, before I read what was prepared, I did want to start a poem that I wrote specifically for the occasion and thinking of Seth. But it's only the first line. It's, there was a man from Nantucket.
Would you please go on?
And if you don't know it, Google it. So the first is a quote by Nikki Rowe. I'm going to go away from the speaker a little bit here. Love is a commitment to cherish another's heart as if it were your own. It is an adventure to seek into all that creates them. It is laying under the stars and dreaming far and wide. It is seeing fear and grabbing each other to face it anyway. It is allowing another to be themselves without your consent. It is knowing when darkness fills them. You don't have to carry their burden, just lighten their load. And if your love isn't as beautiful as this, why have you been loving the wrong one for so long? And the second poem is called Soulmates. Soulmates aren't just anyone you meet. They are souls you instantly have a connection with. They are souls who sometimes know you better than you know yourself. They are the ones who can almost hear your thoughts without you uttering a word. You find comfort in their presence, and you are understood in their silence. They represent love and danger. You come alive with them here. You have a longing to know them, hate only they.
And now we're going to have Ava and Rowan come forward, and we're going to do a unity ceremony with the four of them. A rock has long been used by hikers and travelers to show others that they're on the right path. And like building a family together, building a rock garden that's actually going to stand requires balance, care, and attunement to the different facets and needs of each piece. So,
these ones are all
first.
So now for their vows. Seth and Lindsey have chosen their own unique way to decide who speaks first.
Seth, my love. When we first met, it seemed we had insurmountable odds stacked against us. To name just a few, we started officially dating at the beginning of COVID, a worldwide pandemic. I have two teenagers and thought you never wanted children. I mean, we met at a skate park of all places. But I knew pretty quickly that you were my person. From the beginning, you had this beautiful way of both challenging me and making me feel the safest and most cared for I ever had. Within a few short weeks, you intimately knew me, heart and soul, like we had been together for years. You fell in love with me, Ava, Rowan, Scout, and eventually brother. And we fell madly in love with you. But you had a pivotal life decision to make. No. Continue to live just for your life, just for yourself, or fully and fearlessly embark on this relationship, knowing what it would require of you. I thank you every day for your unwavering commitment to me and this family. Our little family that we've created somehow works. It's been a privilege watching you step into the role of a loving partner, father, and leader in our home. I am so, so proud of you. It's difficult to put into words the connection between our souls, the unexplainable way we know what the other is thinking or feeling when no words are spoken, the way the universe aligns so perfectly, confirming we are exactly where we're meant to be. I could say the words "I love you" a million times every single day for the rest of my life, and it would not come close, would not touch the way I feel about you. The journey to you was long, but I'm truly grateful for every heartbreak, every hardship, because they showed me what I deserve and they taught me how to love. You are what I deserve, and I could not ask for a better life partner and best friend. I promise to tenderly care for your heart and always encourage you to pursue your past passions and dreams. I will be your biggest cheerleader and celebrate your wins with you. And when you've had a particularly hard day, I will hold you and help you momentarily forget the world. You are my home. And I love how you do the same for me. When we are 80, I will still be laughing at your corny jokes and goofy personality that I love so much. For example, when you fart and say, "Is there a duck in here?" Just awful. Or the adorable way you get this bashful look and hold your arms behind your back when you think I look really pretty, which happens a lot. You show me how to enjoy life in the moment and focus on the important things. Remember the golf balls. We've had some epic adventures and experiences, and I cannot wait for those that have yet to come. I solemnly swear not to ride you too hard about the awful way you load the dishwasher. And I accept this marriage fully knowing that I will spend a lifetime going behind you to do it the right way. Oh, and baby, I'll make you a sandwich anytime you want. This day is about us, but it's also a union of our amazing family and friends. We would not be standing here today as the people we are without you all. Thank you all so much for making this trek up to the mountains and for your unconditional support and love. It means the world to us. Neither of us is perfect. We will make mistakes. But I vow to never stop trying to be the very best version of myself for you. I will continue to grow alongside you, and we will enjoy our beautiful life together. You chose me in our love, and I promise to choose you and only you every single day for the rest of my life. I'm so honored I get to call myself your wife after this. I love you with all my heart forever and ever.
That's going to be hard to back up. So everyone knows that Lindsey and I met at a skate park. Rough start, right? And I'm in skate mode, and the only thing that gets my attention is this stunning late 20s blonde woman at the opposite side of the park. It's a gorgeous day out, and now there's a gorgeous woman in my line of sight. And guess what? I've been skating since fourth grade, and now I've got someone to show off for, complete stranger status aside. Of course, there's more to the story, but in the interest of our collective time here today, thank you, everybody. She asked me how old I was and gave me her telephone number. Like, life, no way. Lee was there that day. Was I happier there that day? Give that man the mic real quick.
He was happier.
And this is, so the adventure started in an aggressive fashion. And all I'm saying is an attractive female giving you their number. Ever? Yeah, you sort your life out and do whatever it takes to keep that woman in your life. The kids can come too. How does one man tell the woman that he loves that it has gone beyond wanting to spend my life with you and very much upon you, but also that it... But it has truly arrived at the point that I know that this is exactly where I am supposed to be. I am with the best person I could ever hope to be with. I love everything I am. With. I love you with everything I am, Lindsey. There we go. You're more than I ever could have hoped for, and you're better, you're absolutely better than I deserve. Everyone here today knows that. I am humbled to be your husband. I get to be this man for you. And what you continue to teach me is that I'm getting ever better at it. I want you for life, and these are honestly just the formalities. In 40 years from now, I can only hope that we get to revisit today mentally and laugh more, and I cannot be happier, and my heart cannot be more full. That's what I've got.
A moment of truth time. Lindsey Nicole Belden, will you take Seth to be your husband? Seth James Dobson, will you take Lindsey to be your wife?
Right.
here at the end for anyone who wishes to stand and share a reflection, a quick story of what this ceremony means to you or how the couple has impacted their lives. This can be popcorn style, you can stand up, we can take the mic to you, and it's just free form and open just to continue this circle of love that we have.
I won't be able to make it through, but in case anybody doesn't know, I'm Lindsey's dad. The one thing that every parent wishes for their child is for them to be happy. And it just makes me so happy to see Lindsey as happy as she is. It's been a long road. She's had to overcome so much hardship and so much setback. It's just, I couldn't be more proud of her, where she is in her life, her beautiful family, her beautiful extended family. And I'm just, I hope I'll be able to save this moment in my heart for the rest of my life. A beautiful start to a beautiful couple, a beautiful family, in one of the beautiful, most beautiful locations in the world. It's just perfect. I'm so proud of you. I love you, Lindsey. And you too, Seth.
My son wants to speak too, so let me let him speak first.
Okay, what's up to me?
I just wanted to say that my dad was like a mess before you came in to work with him. And you helped him a lot out of his business.
Oh,
you're grateful.
And I'm grateful for that.
Thanks, Jordan. Yeah.
And you're pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah. It's okay. Yeah.
Thank
you, Jordan. That's
incredible. Yeah. So I've known Lindsey for 4 years, somewhere in there.
COVID, yeah.
Yeah. And Seth about maybe a year after that. What Carrie said about your capability, Lindsey, is spot on. But there is this beautiful gentleness that balances that power. And it's amazing to witness and amazing to know you from that. Seth, you always like hit me up and you're like, dude, you're such this amazing guy. I want to be you when I grow up. Shit. You fucking inspire me already. Like, you are a fearless motherfucker. And the other thing that's amazing about you is this, like, there's no judgment from Seth. There isn't. We all judge everybody else, unconsciously, consciously, with our words, with our mouths, with our thoughts. I've never heard you judge another human being. And I've spent a lot of quality time with you. That's a hell of a character trait. You admire, you inspire me to be a better human being. Thank you.
I'm Sally, I'm Seth's mother. Seth, since you were a little boy, you've been an adrenaline junkie, which, you know, you're at the skate park in your 30s. Form is still the same. I could pick you out of a crowd just by the way you hold your arms. And I think you met the woman after a long road of your own things that you've overcome. I'm very proud of you. And one of the things I'm very proud of you for right now is that you've picked such a lovely woman with two great children. I got bonus grandbabies out of this. And I just love you both so much. And I think if you just remember each other and be kind in your thought, words, and your deeds, you got this. No problem. I'm so proud of both of you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
ever since I was little. Seth has been a daredevil, like she said, jumping off of 80-foot train bridges with me to leaving my ass hanging out when he goes skydiving for his 18th birthday, and I'm still 17 and a half. Skate parks, weeks at the lake, wakeboarding with our other cousins on the other side, everything, man. It's been a great adventure. Hawaii with the family. Lindsey, met you at Claire and Joan's wedding, and it was a great time, and your kids are amazing. Rowan's a little annoying, but I love the little guy. I'm just kidding, buddy. It was great. Yes, I'm kidding. But from pulling him out of trees 10 feet up to seeing you guys interact, drunk, whatever, everything, seeing you, all your elements, Seth talking about the bodacious waves that haven't rolled through the freight trains. You guys were great. I remember the first time Seth told me that, you don't remember that? Anyway. I remember when Seth told me he was found this great girl, and I was like, oh yeah. So I immediately friended her on Facebook because I had to find out what this lady was about. And I started messaging her, and he was like, bro, you're trying to take my woman now? Please back off. And I was like, no. Hey, I wish you all the best, and you guys have everything I've seen. You guys have what it takes to make it, and I wish you all the best.
Reception, so we can see Seth and Lindsey dance, because you dance.
Who near him?
In 1992, he took away the wedding reception dancing for all of us. He's a dancer.
What were we, three? I know, right?
Yeah.
I was like 3 years
old. Yeah.
AJ,
oh no, I'm doing it later.
So Seth and Lindsey Dobson.
I'll leave it in.
Thank you for being the people you are. Thank you for loving us. For loving one another, for being brave enough to take this great adventure together. Congratulations, you are officially husband and wife.
Wife! Yeah.